Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters.
Good morning, Father.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends in Jesus Christ, in today's first reading, St. Paul is encouraging us to empty ourselves in the service of others. That's why he gives best example, best model for us, that is the virtue of humility that is there in the person of Jesus Christ. In the first reading he says, Jesus Christ emptied himself, he humbled himself, which means those who humble themselves, they will be exalted. That is the message we get from the St. Paul. So remember the times where we took pride and asked God to forgive the times to participate worthily in this Holy Mass. Let us acknowledge our sins and shortcomings. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words,
in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my faults,
through my most grievous faults. Therefore, I ask every virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading, please take page number 196 of the New Testament. The first reading is taken from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians, chapter 1, verses 18 to 26, on page number 196 of the New Testament. Christ is proclaimed, and in that I rejoice. Yes, and I shall rejoice, for I know that through your prayers and the help of the Spirit of Jesus Christ, this will turn out for my deliverance, as it is my eager expectation and hope that I shall not be at all shamed, but that with full courage now, as always, Christ will be honored in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me to live in Christ and to die is a gain. If it is to be life in the flesh, that means fruitful labor for me. Yet, which I shall choose, I cannot tell. I'm hard pressed between the two. My desire is to depart and be with Christ, for that is far better. But to remain in the flesh is more necessary on your account. Convinced of this, I know that I shall remain and continue with you all for your progress and joy in the faith, so that in me you may also have ample cause to glory in Christ Jesus because of my coming to you again. The word of the Lord. Our responsory psalm is taken from Psalm 42, and the verses are from 2 to 5. And our response to the psalm. My soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life. My soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life. Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul is yearning for you, my God. Our response, my soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life. My soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life. When can I enter and see the face of God? Our response, my soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life. I will lead the rejoicing crowd into the house of God amid cries of gladness and thanksgiving and the strong wild with joy. Our response, my soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life. Acclamation.
God has spoken to his people, hallelujah. His words are words of wisdom, hallelujah.
You shine as light in the world, holding fast the word of life.
Open your ears, O Christian people, open your ears and hear good news. Open your hearts, O royal priesthood, God has come to you.
God has spoken to his people, hallelujah. And his words are words of wisdom, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Chapter 14, verses 1 and 7 to 11. One Sabbath, when Jesus went to eat a meal at the house of a ruler who belonged to the Pharisee, they were watching him. Jesus told a parable to those who were invited. When he marked how they chose the places of honor, saying to them, when you are invited by anyone to a marriage feast, do not sit down in a place of honor. A more eminent man than you may be invited by him. And he who invited you, both will come and say to you, give place to this man, and then you will begin with the same to take the lowest place. But when you are invited, go and sit in the lowest place, so that when your host comes, he may say to you, "Friend, go up higher." Then you will be honored in the presence of all who sit at the table with you. For everyone who exalts himself will be humbled, and he who humbles himself will be exalted. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear friends in Jesus Christ, you know about Lucifer, the devil. So originally Lucifer was the angel of God, and it was cast out from heaven for what? Because of his pride. The Lucifer tried to set his throne above the throne of God. Then we can see the pride is there in her. Which means, St. Augustine says clearly, it is the pride that made angels to become devils. And it is the humility that makes men as angels. Once somebody asked St. Francis of Assisi, how we are able to do so much work, what is the reason? Then he said, one day God looked down from heaven to see a lowest man, to see a poorest man, to see a weakest man. Then he found me. I am the weakest, I am the poorest man. And God said, through him I can work a lot. Which means, he's not that much showing that I am the great, but he humbled himself. He's very lowest, which means he's decreasing himself. In the same way, in today's gospel, Jesus is speaking about the humility. We have to humble himself. Jesus humbled himself. He emptied himself also. In the same way, when you are invited for any feast, some people are there. They look for higher places. Which means, it is not you who decides to sit there. It is the God who decides. That's what we see in the gospel. When the James, his brother, came and asked the place to sit at the right hand and the left hand, Jesus clearly says, it is not my will, it is the will of my Father who decides the place for you. What is the message from today's gospel that Jesus is giving us? Try to be humble, then you will be exalted. Some people, they feel that I am the great here, nobody is there. I am greater than others. The rest of the society is useless. We feel that. Those who think Jesus is giving message to them, don't feel like that. Don't take pride. Be humble and ask God to give us the grace to acquire the virtue of humility, so that one day we too will be like angels praising God in heaven. May God bless you all.
Accept, Almighty Father, these gifts of bread and wine, which now the priest is offering for us before thy shrine. But soon the word will make them his body and his blood, the sacrifice renewing, once offered on the roof. With these all the
pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice from your hands for the praise and glory of yours, his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, for most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as your Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, fulfilling our will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare our glory, as with one voice we acclaim:
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we bring by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that parting in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis of Pope and Tumma Bala of Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, especially Romy Fernandez, Antumani Paul, Mary Victoria. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and found by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come,
thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours from now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room.
Only say the word,
and my soul shall be.
Hymn number 278.
Hymn number 278. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Kindly turn to page number 235, hymn number 857. For the act of consecration to the Immaculate Heart of Mary. Let us all recite together. I, a faithless sinner, renew and ratify today in thy hands, O Immaculate Mother, the vows of my baptism. I renounce Satan, his forms and works, and give myself entirely to Jesus Christ, the incarnate wisdom, to carry my cross after him all the days of my life, and to be more faithful to him than I have ever been before. In the presence of all the heavenly court, I choose thee this day for my mother and mistress. I deliver and consecrate to thee as thy slave my body, my soul, my goods, both interior and exterior, and even the value of all my good actions, past, present, and future, living to thee the entire and full right of disposing of me and all that belongs to me without exception, according to thy good pleasure, for the greater glory of God in time and eternity. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Mary, help of Christians.
Let us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in science, we may one day possess in truth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
For the final hymn, please take hymn number 476. 476.